What's up, guys? I'm on.
What's your name?
Zephaniah.
What table are we?
On table one.
Table two.
Table two.
What team are you?
Team Lion.
All right.
Say, but his delight.
No, always be right.
Is in the law of the Lord.
And not the Lord.
Say it.
Mm-mm.
Say his delight.
What delight?
Is in the law of the Lord.
With the Lord.
And in his law.
In what?
He meditates.
Takes.
Day and night.
Day and night.
Psalms 1:1. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of the sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful.
Who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of the sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful.
Psalms 1:1. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of the sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful.
What's up, everybody? Congratulations to all our ZBS graduates out there and ZBS.
Bless the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of the sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. Psalms 1:1.
Okay, go ahead, say it.
Nor stands in the path of sinners.
And sits.
No, sits.
Of the scornful.
In this.
Psalms 1:1.
Still in the wall.
There's a man who walks not in the counsel of godly. Or stands in the path of sinners. Nor sits. Let's see. Oh, scoffle.
Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. Psalms 1:1.
This is going to be one awesome memory that we're all going to be able to remember for the rest of our lives.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Number one, thank you everybody for coming on here. We are overwhelmed with the response.
Get you at your best. Zoom Bible School.
Hi, this is Kelsey, Table 8 helper. I just want to say that I'm very proud of all our ZBS students. You guys did an amazing job on their crafts, their color sheets, their fill-ins. Their moms did an awesome job as well.
I'm going to miss all my students. You guys are amazing. I'm so proud of every one of you guys. It was really cool to see all you guys get on Zoom with us and learn about God and make our crafts together.
Hey!
If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. It's an ape. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. Let's see if we can catch it on the tape.
Hello, kids. If you're watching this video, you've been selected for Team Monkey. And at Team Monkey, we're only winners. At Team Monkey, we have the best manners because we're monkeys. And we love cereal. We do our memory work. And we do a lot of off-day work. Like, well, we'll get to that. And I'm just letting you kids know, we're going to win it all. And we're going to squash Team Lion. All right. Goodbye.
Hey there, Lion Cubs. This is Marty Lion. Just wanted to let you know, give you a heads up. I don't think Mr. Monkey knows, but I do, and I'm going to help you get ahead. Make sure and to do your arts and crafts and post them on Kids Corner this week. That'll get you extra points. Let's make sure and do that, and let's do our off-day work, and memorize all our verses, because we're Team Lion, and we got a good memory. We'll memorize everything, and we're going to win. Mr. Monkey thinks he could beat us, but he can't, And let's make sure and use our table manners, which is being kind to our friends and our teachers and listening and obeying. So let's be good. And we're going to crush that monkey. And then we could go eat all the food we want. I got chicken nuggets for everybody. So, Team Lion.
Alan, I'm at table 3 at DBS, and one of my favorite things about this is seeing all the kids' posts and all their videos. It really shows how much time the kids are putting into the Word of God, and how much time the moms are putting into the Word of God.
But Jesus says to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang the law and the prophets."
Hello, I'm Katie Stevens of Table 9. And I just wanted to get on here real quick and say how much we enjoy DBS. Me and Nick and the kids, we all enjoyed it and we learned a lot from it. And it was great getting on there and seeing them 60-some cameras. All ages and all the different states, 3 times a week, on time, faithfully.
I love seeing the kids' faces, how they light up in the morning, how they're anxious and excited to learn about God and His Word. And it's just so amazing, this Zoom, how the Word of God is going right directly into homes, into households. And the Word of God is God's life. It's His very breath. And it's going right into homes.
"These words which I command you today," ready, "shall be in your heart." So it was always about the heart with God.
It was a blessing and an honor to be a part of. And one of my favorite things that I could not get over was that ZBS was all throughout the United States. From here to Florida to New York, up north, it was all over.
It's been amazing, amazing opportunity. I feel so blessed to be a part of it, to be able to share and spreading God's gospel, getting His word out to His lambs and His sheep and to all the families. Very sad that it's over. I gotta say though, I'm so blessed and thankful for what God did through ZBS.
What is your greatest need? Your greatest need is to fulfill God's greatest commandment.
First of all, I love the main room in the morning, seeing all the kids, from the 2 years old to the teenagers and the moms, so excited and eagerly waiting to hear God's word. And then second of all, my next most favorite team is in our breakout room. When the kids would comment about the lesson that we learned that day, their insight was so great, so amazing. Their insight gave me insight, and they blessed me so much with their comments. The kids and the moms in that room, their insight was outstanding.
I just wanted to thank everybody for joining in with us at ZBS. I think it was an awesome experience. I'm really proud of Table 5. You guys did a really great job showing up and doing your work. I love doing arts and crafts with you guys and seeing you on the screen. And it was really amazing how God put us all together and He put us in the right room, and how that screen would just go away and we would have Sunday school together.
And then those kids, oh my gosh, I don't know what to say. Everything sticks out. From Lexi and Lizzie, these girls, their answers, they always brought it up to a different preset. To Gabe, you know, that means snake. He made for sure let the class know who the mean snake is.
I really did enjoy ZBS. I think my most favorite thing was seeing all the kids come on in the morning. You see all their faces. It was just so good to see all them faces, and they smile. Those smiles really get to me. And then doing the arts and crafts with them and seeing those color pages. I love those color pages. And I remember a few of the kids, when that Mr. Marty come on, their eyes got so excited. I think that was my favorite part, seeing their faces.
How your childhood you have been acquainted with, so he's familiar with the Bible. Ready? And what's the purpose? Why make your kid familiar with the Bible? Here's why. Because they are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Jesus Christ. If you want to leave an inheritance to your children, leave an eternal inheritance of salvation to every one of our kids. Because the reality...
But... Oh, hello, kids. It's me, Mr. Monkey. And I guess if all you kids are looking at me...
It might mean...
One thing. It's graduation night. I just want to say congratulations, kids, for making it through ABC or ZBS. I forgot. I'm really not sure. But it's been a good time with all you guys, watching you guys do your memory verses, watching you guys just be well behaved. And it brings a tear to my eye that it's getting close to being over. But most importantly, you guys are equipped with the Word of God, and that's all you need. So now, we're gonna go look back at all the hard work you guys did to get yourselves here to graduation night. And I got one more question. Why are you guys upside down? Oh, wait a minute. I think I'm upside down. Uh-oh. Ah! Roll the footage.
Everybody repeat after me. Say, God is
the boss.
God is the boss. That's our first lesson.
Okay, and God is the
boss. Jesus loves the little children. The children of the world.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was out form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light.
All the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in His sight. Jesus cares for all the children of the world.
Wow. So since God made everything, that means He's the boss of everything. Because He's in charge of everything that He created. And God has family.
Adam, Eve, and the
garden. Jesus came to save the children.
We are made in His image. And we are made in His likeness. We're God's family. Amen? God's good eyes watch over everything He created. Say,
God
has eyes.
Do not He see my ways and count all my steps?
For the ways of men are before the eyes of the Lord, and He ponders all His goings.
Adam and Eve was perfect. They didn't have no sin. They was perfect. They had perfect fellowship with God. He had one rule.
They couldn't eat the apple. And they were created because God wanted them to be because He wanted family and
family.
Family.
Yeah.
And He wanted fellowship. They ate the apples and God kicked them out.
Cause why?
Cause they was a poison.
Eat the apple. No.
So how'd that make God feel that He had to kick him out of the garden?
Very, very sad because I was with family and fellowship.
Don't worry about it.
Ate the apple!
What did Adam and Eve do?
Ate the apple from the tree.
Yep, it was from a tree. But who told them to eat the apple?
Let me see.
Eat the stump of it, not the tree.
froze.
Really?
Because they ate the apples.
Really? Then what happened?
Then they got out got them because flaming servant angel.
What did Adam and Eve
apple,
eat?
Apple.
An apple, you know?
And the snake is turning. He's dead. I hate him now.
Okay, we don't say hate.
So, when Adam and Eve ate the apple, they were naked. And the snake told them that they were naked. And they disobeyed God. So God had to kill an animal and they covered their body.
Listen, this is why we say God forgive us for our sins and our prayers. Because when we sin, He gives us new blood, which is blood of mercy.
But God made him something. What did He make him?
Clothes.
Yeah, He made him clothes so they could be part of His family again, right?
They got kicked out of the garden.
They sure did. How come?
Because Jesus told them not to eat the fruit off the tree.
Yep, and did they eat the fruit?
Yeah.
Yes, they ate the fruit.
He made them clothes, but they got kicked out of the garden, and there was an angel standing out there, and they holded up a sword, Ma? And so they couldn't come back.
Blessed is the man who walks not in the council of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful.
What does the scripture mean?
We are blessed when we don't listen to the ungodly, or follow them or anything, or we don't talk bad or anything about people.
Blessed the man who walks not in the council of the council of the ungodly, and who walks not in the council of the ungodly. Did I say that again?
Yeah.
My name is Vashti, so I'm gonna learn you my memory verse. So watch. Blessed the man who walks not in the council.
Psalm 1:1. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful.
Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful.
Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful.
Psalms 1:1. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scornful.
We're eating our fur coats that God made for them. He showed mercy, and we're eating their coats. This is either sheep or a polar bear.
Mm.
I'm going to say it's wool sheep.
Mm. I say it's a polar bear.
One, two, three.
Oh, that's amazing. Thank you.
Hey, kids. It's good to see you. You guys have been really great with ZBS. I'm proud of you. Keep up the good work. Week one was lots of fun. It was really cool. Let's check out week two.
Who built the ark?
Noah.
Who built the ark?
Mother Noah built the ark.
Who built the ark?
Noah.
Who built the ark?
Brother Noah built the ark.
Old man Noah built the ark.
Uh-huh.
He built it out of hickory bark.
That's right.
He built it long, both wide and tall, with plenty of room for the large and small.
Who built the ark?
Noah.
Who built the ark?
Brother Noah built the ark.
Who built the ark?
God had Noah get all the animals and Noah's family, and he placed them in an ark for safety because there was a great flood that was going to come on the earth. So the Lord was making a way for safety, just like he made a way in last week with the coats of skin, with the coverings.
Two big cats and a bumblebee.
Who built the ark?
Noah, Noah.
Who built the ark?
Brother Noah built the ark.
Who built the ark?
Noah, Noah.
Who built the ark?
Brother and the world began to grow, and a lot of people lived on the earth during this time. They had grandkids and great-grandkids. More and more people were born, and the mean snake was going from house to house to all the families, trying to trick all the families into thinking that they could be their own boss and that God is not the boss. And the sad part is, everybody listen.
Who built the ark?
Noah, Noah.
Who built the ark?
Brother Noah built the ark.
I think I got a bee up my nose.
Because he's where?
Because he's in the whale.
Snake is in the world. The people who listen to him have a mean heart. And God made the flies to stop the beast.
Yes.
Wherefore, as by one man, who's the one man? Adam. By one man, sin. Sin means to try and be your own boss and break what God says, right? Wherefore, by one man, sin entered the world.
Elena's ark. We got all our animals loaded up. Now what? We've got to get on the ark?
Yes, we do.
Why?
Because the water's coming slow.
Oh.
Do you guys think God knows if the world is following the mean snake?
Yes.
How does God know?
Because he has eyes.
That's right, Daddy. So, God's going to keep his family safe. How is he going to keep them safe?
Time for the voyage to begin. Noah said,
God's family's going to be safe on what? The ark, exactly.
So God said that his flood is going to come, and it's going to wipe out the mean snake and all his followers. But no, there's another verse that we want to read. Verse 8. But Noah, he found grace in the eyes of God. So God,
he got in the boat.
He got in the boat. And who went in the boat with him? Who he took with him?
Jesus.
Who else?
Everyone inside the ark was safe. Noah and his family were very happy.
God gave him a second chance and he left the door open until like the last second. And he gave him a second chance because nobody believed in God except for Noah. And
do you remember who closed the door on the ark?
God.
God closed the ark.
We made Noah's ark to show when he parked it, and he put a rainbow in the sky to show that that God would never flood the earth again.
Is that his promise?
Yeah. The rainbow is God's promise.
What did God put in the sky?
Rainbow!
Wow, that was God's promise, right?
Yeah.
Huh? That was his promise?
Yeah. Mom. It was first, Mom.
I know, Mom.
Psalms 1:2.
But. His delight.
His delight.
Is in.
The law. He meditates a day and night.
In the law of the Lord.
In the law of. He meditates out of day and night.
That's the man who. Not going to godly.
And that is what? Psalms 1:1.
And his delight.
But his delight?
His delight meditates day and night.
His delight in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night.
Psalms 1:2. But in his delight. In the law of the Lord, and in his law, he meditates day and night. Okay, here's the one, the Bible, right here, thing.
Truly, truly, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. I am the door, and by me, if any man enters in, he shall be saved.
And it never fails.
Satan thinks he's gonna triumph over me. Then Jesus says I got the victory. When there's a problem, I spray a little water to the Father, every Father. Need you to know my worship and my praise. Jesus.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make an alignment to my feet and a light into my path. And will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God. Amen.
And he shall be like a tree. Planted by the rivers of water.
Satan thinks he's gonna triumph over me. But Jesus says I got the victory. When there's a problem, I'm
the first week we learned that Adam and Eve, God designed a perfect family, and they chose to sin and try and be their own boss. So God had to find a way to save them. So God spoke. God looked down with his big eyes. Look at me. God used his big eye. God looked around the whole earth. That's and he scary. Said there was no one who was in his family.
Oh, Jesus, I got shout. So you've been delivered. You've been set free. He broke in the chains. Now I am free. Jesus Christ.
God wants to come and invite Abraham into his family.
This is an invitation to God's family. And the inside says,
what it says?
I'm part of God's family. And, and Jesus loves me. And,
Jesus, I got you. I said I'm blessed. I said I'm blessed.
As now the Lord had said unto Abraham, get out of your country and from thy family and from thy father's household. Go unto a land that I will show you. I will make thee a great nation. I will bless thee and make thy name great. And thou shalt be a blessing, and I will bless them that bless you, and curse them that curse you.
And on the inside, it says, I'm part of God's family, and on the
other side,
it says, Jesus loves me, John 3:16.
Many sons had Father Abraham, I am one of them, and so are you. So let's all praise the Lord.
Right arm, left arm.
God is righteous. Abraham was not righteous, right? But Abraham believed God, so God treated him as if he was righteous.
Right arm, left arm, right foot,
falling over.
Father Abraham had many sons. Many sons had Father Abraham. I am one of them, and so are you. So let's all praise the Lord.
Right arm, left arm, right foot, left foot. Hey, look out! Hey, I
almost took out my... Must. We must believe in the promised son to be in God's family.
Invitation?
Yes.
And who lives in your heart?
God.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Show me where. Right there. This is our invitation from God. And then we open it. It's John 3:16. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world, he gives one and only son. Shall ever believe in him shall not perish but have an everlasting life.
If you are in the Bible, by the way, day and night, you look at you and expect the rivers of water, but brings forth fruit and ceases. The leaf plant wasn't there, but it does not pass through.
Snap! He'll be like a tree, don't tell her.
A little water.
He'll bring.
A fruit season.
Very good.
Okay. Blessed the man who walks not to the counsel of the ungodliness, or stands in the path of sinners, or sits in the seat of scornful, but his delight in the law of the Lord, he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, and bring forth to its fruit of its season. Whatever he does shall prosper.
And blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked or stand in the way that st-
sinners,
take all set in the company of Marcus.
Right.
Is in the law of the Lord. And in his law, he meditates. He meditates day and night.
He is in the law of the Lord. In his law, he meditates day and night. Psalms 1:2.
Hi. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seats of the scornful. Psalms 1:1.
He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth and its fruit in its season. And his leaf also shall not wither. And whatever he does shall prosper.
He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, who brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaves shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Psalms 1:3.
Trey, look at me, Ma. He shall be like
a tree. Water.
Mm-hmm. That brings forth its
fruit
in a season.
Whose leaves shall not wither.
And what he does, shall prosper.
Psalms 1:3.
The greatest commandment God had was given to parents.
I just want to say a special thanks and congratulations to all the moms out there. I mean, you guys done an amazing job week after week, class after class, over the last 5 or 6 weeks in the midst of, you know, I'm sure dealing with husbands and kids and life in general. It's such a blessing to us to see that. And I know I speak for all of our team when I say it has been a privilege and an honor to serve you guys and to be able to share in fulfilling the greatest commandment that the Lord gave us, right? That this is a partnership. The family and the local church come together and we walk out that greatest commandment that Jesus gave us. And this is something that I know I'll remember for the rest of my life, just coming on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday and seeing all them faces on there, all the babies. It's such a blessing seeing all the moms on there just training their kids. It's such a great legacy that's being left and the imprint that is going to put in the heart of all these babies and such a great image of God. That I know even the points, they're nursery and they're tailored for kids, but there's eternal truths that I'll take for the rest of my life. I know he spoke to me and all the moms and all of our staff. And, you know, God is the boss and God has eyes and God has family.
Also, Friday, our last day is ABS. Jack got the scissors and trimmed my hair while we were doing our lesson. That was a pretty good, memorable moment. I'm thankful for the moms and the babas who came on and helped with their grandkids throughout our lessons.
ZBS personally changed me and my family, and it brought the Lord in our home in a different way because my kids were sharing with us more than us sharing with them. So that was a wonderful blessing.
I enjoyed seeing all you moms, how you work hard at learning your kids. And I remember a student with one mom. He was putting glue all over the windows in his trailer. And the mom, instead of quitting, she worked hard. And now she sets him on the kitchen floor. And I think that's awesome how you guys adapted. And you took time for the Lord. And you put him in your everyday life.
And it's so amazing that these babies are getting God's word at this early age. Though, you know, the word of God says, train a child in the way he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart.
I love all the kids and the moms at table 6. You and ZBS will always have a very special place in my heart. As long as I live, I love yous. And thank you, moms, and thank you, kids, for giving me the opportunity to share the word of God with you. And I am so privileged and blessed to take part in ZBS.
Special thanks to all the moms out there who got on every week. You guys are awesome. It takes dedication, and you can really see your devotion to God. And I just wanted to say, keep up the good work. It was really a blessing to be on there with you guys every week, and hopefully we see you guys soon, and keep up the good work.
And then even the moms, the answers, they would help me teach, and it truly was a privilege and an honor. Congratulations, ZBS 2021.
It's your guy Dino here, coming on to let you know that every week we're going to be having brand new Bible stories here on Kids Corner. So you make sure to tune in, you're not going to want to miss it. See, we've been talking all like ZBS this and ZBS that, and ZBS is cool, but ZBS is coming to an end. But Kids Corner is still going to be here every Sunday with a brand new Bible lesson. So you're not going to want to miss it. So make sure, look us up, and watch us every Sunday. Harvest Time, Kids Corner. Okay? Bye!
One guy and one teammate.
Good job.
Bye. I'm going to do my very best. Blessed is the man who don't walk on the counsel of ungodly, that stands at the sinner on the full world. After I after all the world and sinner, and meditate day, day, night.
And a new king came up. And this king is named the Mean King. Because the Mean King works for the Mean Snake. The Mean King is trying to take all of God's family as slaves to work for him.
Like the Israelites. He made them work hard. One day, Pharaoh decided to get rid of all the Israelites' baby boys.
God is going to take care of the Mean King.
God told, what's his name, Moses, go tell Pharaoh, let the Israelites go. But then Pharaoh said, okay, I'll let him go. And then he changed his mind and he said no.
God sent a secret agent named Moses.
Moses.
He said, he's a agent.
And this one craft is Moses and the burning bush.
And what did God tell him?
To take off his sandals because it's in holy wax.
And where did he send him?
To save his family from the Mean King.
I am
soldier.
And my Jesus saw me.
Okay. One bus. One kingdom. One family. One family.
One kingdom.
Down. God has come down from heaven. Why? to deliver them from the power of Egyptians.
God sent the plagues and all the bad people, the boo-boos.
God gave them so many times to come and they didn't want to, but he still wanted to, he still wanted to save them, but it was their choice not to do it, but he still wanted to.
Every time God would do a plague, Moses would go and say, "Let my people go." And he would say, "No, I won't do it."
One boss, one kingdom, one family.
And who's the one boss?
God.
Who's the one kingdom?
God.
And who's family?
God.
Family.
One boss.
One boss.
One kingdom.
One kingdom.
One family.
So it says, "And the blood shall be to you for a token upon the houses where ye are." And this is what God says. When I see the blood, say that. Say, "When I see the blood." When God sees the blood, he says, "I will pass over. I will pass over, and the plague," or the weapon, "God's weapon shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land of Egypt."
And can you tell us now, what did God tell his people, his family, to put on the door?
Blood.
Did you run?
No. Jesus spoke the blood.
Okay. Where do you put the blood?
On a new hawk on the door, on the popsicle stick.
We're gonna reclaim everything that devil stole.
We're gonna tear the devil's king.
And here comes Pharaoh's army marching in the middle of that ocean, going after him. And guess what happened? God seen his people. And he also seen the wicked people. And guess what he did? He closed that ocean up right on all the Egyptians. And that day, the Egyptians was no more. They could no more hurt God's people. God destroyed them all. The mean king and all the mean kingdom was destroyed that day.
So what you think something that we could learn from that?
Like how Moses trusted God and his plan always works.
Do we lose?
No, never.
Boss, one kingdom, one family.
Boss, one kingdom, one tame lion, table seven.
One family.
One family.
One boss, one family, one kingdom.
Prosperity, peace in our homes and our communities, righteousness in our government. These are things the devil.
Who's the boss?
Jesus. God.
God. Does God have a family?
Yes.
Does God have eyes?
Yes.
Who walked through the waters?
The main king.
And what happened to him?
Closed.
What happened?
Closed.
What closed? The waves?
Uh-huh.
Good job.
And guess what happened? The Israelites was set free. They were so happy. They start singing and they start praising the Lord. They was rejoicing and saying, "The Lord saved us.
I've been set free by the blood of the Lamb. I've been set free by the holes in his hands. I've been set free by the crown on his head. I've been set free when he rose from the dead. Jesus has set me free. Oh, Jesus has set me free. Hallelujah. Jesus gave me the victory. He set me free. Oh, Jesus has set me free. Oh, Jesus has set me free. Hallelujah. Jesus gave me." set free. And Jesus wants you to know, wants you to shout and see. Oh, Jesus has set me free. Oh, Jesus has set me free. Hallelujah. Jesus gave me the victory. He set me free. I've been set free by the blood of the Lamb. I've been set free by the wolves in his hands. I've been set free by the crown on his head. Oh.
I've been set free
when he rose from the dead. Jesus has set me free. Oh, Jesus has set me free. Jesus gave me the victory. He set me free. Bye, guys. Have a good day.
Psalms 1:4, New King James Version. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away.
Jesus, and Jesus came, and you know what Jesus did? Jesus lived a perfect life. So you know what that means? Jesus obeyed every one of the Father's commands.
Jesus is the Father's son.
What was in the cup that Jesus drank?
God, anger.
In the cup that Jesus drank?
God, anger.
Very good.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him should not perish. Why are they going to perish? Because there's a weapon that's coming, right? That they should not perish, but have what? Everlasting life.
Hi, I'm Ryan, and I'm a monitor of Table 6 with Natalie. And I'm just going to share what I seen on Natalie's table. And I just thought it was so cool to hear all of the kids' answers on some of the questions on Table Talk. Like, that was so cool. Like, one of them was, do you think God is more committed to his goodness or to his family?
So Jesus is not the secret agent. What is he? He's the promised agent. Jesus is the agent that was promised all the way back in the beginning of the Bible. Jesus came with one mission for two purposes. Jesus' one mission was to do his Father's will. He came to do what his Father wanted him to do. And what was that? Rescue his people and judge the mean king and all of the mean kingdom. He sends his son to us to offer everyone to come in God's family and be safe in him.
He's going to send his son to die for us so that when we don't have to perish, we could go to heaven.
What did Jesus do on the cross?
Die.
For our sins.
What sins?
What was in the cup?
Wrath.
Who drinks the cup?
Jesus.
For what?
For his family.
You and her sins, you're a pleasure to me.
For our sake, he made him to be sin, who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God.
Do you know what Jesus drank out of the cup? He drank the God's anger from sin.
What was in God's cup? It was God's anger of sin.
It was God's anger. Because the mean snake was some bad stuff out of his mouth.
So Jesus drank it?
Yeah.
So do we have to drink it too?
We drink juice.
Only by Jesus can I go to the Father.
Can I go to the Father?
The gospel is the good news.
Yeah, boy!
I'm just not that!
I want you to say this after me. Say, God must.
God must.
Do what is right.
Do what is right.
So we know God loves his family, but God also has to do what's right because God is righteous and he always does what's right.
Far beyond the sky, where I'm gonna shout and sing until the heavens ring. I'll be king, this world will rise.
Hey, God's family.
God's family.
Must be righteous.
Must be righteous.
So we,
what was in the cup? God's anger for sin.
What was in the cup? Jesus' drank. Who's wrath?
God's wrath.
And what do we get to drink?
So God needs to punish his family because they're rejecting him. They're rejecting his offers and they're being their own boss. So what is God to do?
And who is supposed to drink the cup?
Us.
And then what happened?
Jesus drank it and traded places with us. Then he died on the cross.
What did he die on the cross for?
Our sins.
And what do we get to drink now?
Juice.
Jesus died? Where?
On the cross.
Why did he die on the cross?
Because I've been drinking God's anger.
Because in our perfect covering, our perfect door, our perfect land, and our perfect brother.
It was God's wrath and he forgave us for our sins.
Jesus' last words on the cross was, "It is finished."
Straight away, they knew it was his goodness. And you could see that what Jesus died on the cross, because he only didn't do it for his family, but he did it because he saw that it was good and it also bring glory to his name. He saw that it would been good for his name's sake, right?
Of the cross, and he traded places with us so that our sins was on him. Just like the lamb, our sins went on the lamb and God's weapon passed over us. Jesus is our lamb and our sins go on him. And when he was on that cross and he was punished, he took our punishment. And guess what we get? His righteousness. And now we could all be righteous enough to be in God's family because Jesus' death and resurrection. So Jesus is alive, kids. You guys all follow me? Look up at the screen. He's not in the tomb anymore. The tomb is empty. Jesus is alive. He builds him that's very special, a place for all of God's family to come. It's called the church. He says, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. So guess what? He's coming back.
He's coming back.
And what else?
I'm not.
He's coming back. Boss, is Jesus coming back? Is he coming back for you?
When he comes back, with one hand, he's going to take all of his family to himself. And with the other, he's going to take all of the mean kingdom. And they're going to be totally punished, separated for destruction, right? The Bible says. And they'll be put in God's prison, locked up, right? He's going to lock them away so that they could never mess with God's family again. Yeah,
sin, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scornful. Psalms 1:1. 2 is, but in the eyes and the law of the Lord, and in his line meditates day and night. Psalms 1:2. 3 is, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. His leaf also that brings forth in its fruit in its season, and his leaf also shall not wither, and also prosper. Psalms 3:4. The ungodly are not so, but they are like the shaft which the wind drives away. Mm-hmm. Psalms 1:4. 5? Let me think it. Then God shall not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. Psalms 1:5. The Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish.
This is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, who brings forth its fruit in its season, and whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff that the wind drives away. The ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, and the way of the ungodly shall perish. Psalms 1:1-6.
Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of the sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law meditates day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish.
Topic: How to be blessed. Psalms 1:6. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. In his delight in the law of the Lord, and his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth fruit in the season, whose leaf shall not wither, but whatever he does shall prosper. Therefore, the ungodly are not so, but like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners shall not stand in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish.
This is Psalms 1:1-6. Blessed is a man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor stands in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth in its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. The Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. Amen.
Psalms 1:1. Topic: How to be blessed.
The way of the righteous and the end of the ungodly. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bring forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the ungodly shall perish.
Psalms 1:1-6. Blessed the man who walks not in the counsel of ungodly, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scornful. But in his delight in the law of the Lord, he shall meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither. Whatsoever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff that the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. Therefore the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the ungodly shall perish.
The man who walks not in the counsel of ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, he shall meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the edge of the river, which brings forth fruit in its season, and his leaf shall not wither. Whatever he does, he shall prosper. Ungodly are not so; they are like the chaff the wind drives away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in front of judgment, and the ungodly shall not stand in the congregation of righteousness. For the Lord knows the way of the righteousness, but the way of the ungodly you shall perish. New King James Version, Psalms 1-6.
Two men walk in the rain, come to the ungodly, which stand to the path of the sea, which sit to the path of the scornful, which
his?
But his delight is in the law of the Lord.
Yeah, Psalms 1-2.
Psalms 1-2.
Okay. Topic.
Topic.
How to be blessed. Psalms 1:1-2. King James Version.
King James Version.
Alright, say your memory verse.
Blessed the man who walks not in the counsel of ungodly, and stand away sinners, sits in the seat of the scornful. And hears the light and a lot of the Lord, and sits in seat from school.
And in his law.
And in his law.
He
and meditates and stay at night.
Yes. Hi everybody, my name is Amanda and I am at table number 9. I'm a helper. And we just want to say thank you for allowing us to come alongside you to assist you in helping your kids learn the Word of God. And I just want to say, keep up the good work. Every single one of you are amazing. And even though ZBS is over, the Ox family is still here at Kids Corner. Go to our YouTube channel and like and subscribe to Harvest Time Kids Corner. We have new videos every Sunday with Bible lessons and fun activities. So we just want to say thank you again for giving us the privilege to help you. Bye, guys.
Hello, everyone. My name is Karen. I'm monitor at table number 4. And I just wanted to come on here and tell you guys how much I enjoyed having the moms and the girls, the kids. I had all girls at my table. I loved it. Every minute of it. I love boys, too. Anyway, I just wanted to say how wonderful it was, and I can't think of any special moments because they were all so special, and all the girls that were on there are so beautiful and special. I loved it. I loved being on there. I feel so blessed to be a part of it. ZBS Zoom Bible School is amazing.
Hey, what's up, ZBS? My name is Dean, and I'm a table honor for Table 2. I help Ginger. And how ZBS affected me, first off, it's just amazing seeing all these kids, you know, quote the word and doing the arts and crafts and seeing the passion that they have. It's so rewarding and gratifying and building his kingdom, you know, feeding his lambs. And I just think, you know, God's done an awesome job, you know, and I pray that we keep it up, stay faithful. So, God bless, guys.
But I really enjoyed ZBS and Natalie's class and the kids. I liked Pam and David and James. I thought that was pretty cool. I thought Pam was like one of the most coolest people I ever heard. Like hearing how she talks about the gospel and how she talks about it with her kids. It's like it really shows what a strong Christian family is, that you can have conversations with your kids. But I really enjoyed ZBS and Natalie was a really good teacher.
Hi, I'm David. A few things that we learned at ZBS is that God has eyes, so he sees what we do. We also learned that God is the boss and that he is our creator. And another thing that we learned was that we're part of God's family through Christ, because when Jesus died for us, that we have now direct contact with the Father. Some other things that we learned was that we learned the story about Jacob and Esau, and that Esau gave away his eternity just for worldly stuff. So I want to be more like Jacob, because he spent all of his time learning about God more than like worldly stuff, and I really want to be like Jacob. Some other things that we learned the story about Joseph, how he was in slavery because of his brothers through jealousy. His brothers were all jealous that he got that coat. So they all like lied and stuff, and it was very good because God was with him the entire time. So I want to be like, I want to feel like God's right next to me, and this study has really helped me, so thank you.
Hi, I'm James, and I've been going to ZBS for the past couple of weeks now, and I've learned a lot from it. I've learned that we are a part of God's family, which is the most important thing to me, because we have direct access to God through Jesus. We can pray to him when we have struggles. God also has eyes, so he knows every action, even our thoughts, that we don't say to people what we think about our lifestyle. He knows. My favorite lesson that we've learned is Jacob and Esau, especially since Esau declined the invitation of God for a bowl of stew. It made me really hurt. But I want to be like Jacob, where he went and he took the invitation to be a part of God's family. I want to be a part of God's family.
So the lesson that stood out to me most would probably have to be a twin invitations, because it really taught me how to never throw away your eternity for a temporary fix, which is the world, because if we were to do that, it's not going to end up well. It's just going to end up with us and discouragement and everything, because a temporary fix, of course, only lasts a temporary time, but going to God for an eternal fix will be the cure of all of our worriments and our anxieties and everything of the world. So never throw away your eternity for a temporary fix. Don't be set up on the world. Always be set apart from it. You like Jacob? Nice.
So my favorite CBS lesson was lesson 11, The Plagues Are. And that was about the Passover. And what I liked about it was God gave us 9 chances before the dead angel. And then he provided a way for us to be safe from it. In Exodus 12:13, it says, "And the blood shall be a token for you upon the houses where ye are. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land of Egypt." So that when he sees the blood on the door, it will not strike them. That means that their firstborn will not be killed. And what I dislike about Noah's Ark, well, how he held the door open and nobody came in, and that's how much God has mercy for us. But he ends up winning at the end because nobody could come over him. He's the king, he's the provider. But overall, the whole ZBS was good. I liked it, I was excited for it, but I'm sad it's ended.
Hi.
What I learned is God's goodness for dying on a cross for us.
What I got through all the VPSs is how God helped and provided for everyone. Adam and Eve sinned, and he still provided for them.
He has goodness in his heart.
Mm-hmm. And Moses helped God's people to be free by parting the Red Sea.
This is my summary of what we learned today in ZBS. Number one is creation. God spoke and everything listened. God made man in his perfect image, and God is the boss. And number two is the fall. Adam and Eve disobeyed God's command. Eve thought she could be her own boss, and because one man sinned, which is Adam, sin passed upon all men. And in number three, God's perfect plan, they hid from God, they made themselves coverings, and they tried to hide from their sin. And God punished the man, the woman, and the snake. And God showed them mercy by making them a temporary cover made out of skin. And now God promises an eternal covering. And that's in Genesis 3:15. And it says, I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. So this is the promised seed of Jesus. And next is four, the world's rebellion. Sin spread to everyone. All of man's hearts were evil, and man's heart grieved God's heart. And God plans to flood the earth to stop the wicked. And number five, God's perfect plan. God saw Noah's obedience, and God saw the corruption of the world. And number six is God's perfect promise. God stopped all the wicked with the flood, and God saved his family with the ark. They were under the pitch, and that means atonement. And after 40 days and 40 nights, there was God's promise in the sky to never flood the earth again.
Hi, I'm Ryan, and I'm on table six with Natalie, and I'm going to share my favorite teachings that we had from Natalie. And it either has to be Noah, the coats of skin, or the Passover. And with the coats of skin, it really shows that God covered us with his righteousness, that it was through God's work alone. It couldn't been of us, but it was through that shedding of that blood of God's work. That it was a perfect picture that Jesus was God's work, so he could cover us with his righteousness, like 1 Corinthians 5:21, that he who knew no sin became sin. And that's just the perfect picture that we were imputed with God's righteousness. And it's so weird that you could see that in Genesis chapter 3, like in all those books down. And with the Passover, that's just, I don't know how else you could explain it but Jesus, that by the blood of the Lamb, we're safe from God's wrath, that we go in the house and we feast on this Lamb, right, which is when we have a personal relationship and we read his word. But that just shows that Jesus, he drank the cup of anger, and now we're able to drink juice. But it also shows that it was the cup that he gave us, which was his blood. He gave his blood for this new covenant. And that's just so cool. And with the ark, that Jesus is the door, and also that pitch, which is the atonement, that it binds us together, that God's atoning sacrifice that he gave freely because he loves us freely. And that's just the best thing, that it's all about Jesus, that everything's about Jesus.
So my favorite lesson is that is Noah's Ark, because this is what I learned. I learned about Noah's Ark. I always knew about Noah's Ark, right? but I don't know who teaches it like, but they made me look at it in a different way. Like, they made me look at it in a way that he's God always gives people a chance. He made me look at it in that way. I never looked at it that way, Noah's Ark, that God always gives people a chance. Favorite lessons, Noah's Ark, and yeah, they made me look at it in a different way. That's it. I had to summarize it because that video was too long.
What I learned from GBS was we learned about the Passover. What the Passover is, there was 10 plagues, and the 10th plague was the death angel. And what the death angel is, it kills the firstborn. And God made a way for that won't, that won't apply to us. And what that is, the Passover. What the Passover is, you sacrifice a lamb, and you put the blood of the lamb on the door. And then after they do that, they go inside and they feast on the lamb. And what that represents is our relationship with God. And the death angel sees the blood on the door, and it knows it can't go near it. But now we don't need the Passover, because Jesus was our last Passover on the cross. He took away all the sin in the world on the cross, and he was the last sacrifice.
I think my most favoriteest part of all was our breakout rooms graduation video, seeing what each kid learned and took in their heart from ZBS. It was so awesome to me and such a blessing, and it overjoyed me so much that it brought me to tears. Seeing how all the kids got the word of God inside of their hearts and how it was just flowing out of their mouths.
Dedicate your life to God.
This is a good school for me.
It's a good school for you?
Thank you for making VBS.
My. Well, you know, I thank you for coming on.
And I'm very privileged to watch these kids learn the word of God from our crafts. And I have to say, my favorite craft was when we learned that Moses parted the Red Sea. God gave him the power to do that. And God didn't only deliver the Israelites, but he also destroyed their enemies. And I hope that these lessons could stay with us for the rest of our lives.
I think all the teachers did great, and all the moms. We all had unity. Everything worked out so good. We didn't have a lot of issues. Everything kind of just flowed, even though nobody knew what they was doing, messing with this Zoom. And can't wait for next year.
I'm going to miss everybody. Miss seeing everybody's faces and all the crafts and just reading the word and getting to know you guys a little bit. It was great. I loved it. God bless.
I'm gonna miss everybody, but we need to know that just because EBS is over doesn't mean that we're not connected still. Doesn't mean that we can't keep in touch. We are the body, and the body is always one, no matter where we are or what's going on.
Keep that word in your heart. Never, ever, ever forget that. That as long as you live here, the life to come, you will be a part of God's family now and for eternity. And that's what we fix our hope in, amen? Blessing, blessing, blessing.
And what I thought was going to be kid lessons, they are not kid lessons. God's the boss. He has eyes. He takes care of his family. And these are some of the truths that really deepened inside of me. I love the arts and crafts, the coloring pages, especially those little guys, those coloring pages. I really love those. So I just wanted to say thanks to everybody for allowing us to come with you and to help you give your kids the word. So thanks for allowing us to do that. And I just really loved ZBS. I enjoyed it. Thank you. Bye.
Well, guys, ZBS is finished, but the command to love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, thy soul, thy strength, the greatest commandment is not. It continues on. It's a daily duty. It's a privilege and an honor that we wake up every day. Remember, every new day is a new opportunity to leave a legacy to your children and to the generations to come ahead of you of God's faithfulness, that God has eyes and God has family. And God is the boss. And if we live our life to represent that to our children, then they will grow up and your obedience today will leave a legacy and an impact on your kids tomorrow and your grandkids to come. We can transform generations ahead of us by simple daily obedience.
But more than that, folks, we need to be strong in the Lord, the power of His might. Amen.
Amen.
Be strong, Lord. You know what I'm saying there? And you know, and the only way to do that, as I know how, is relationship with Him. Paul said, I might know Him. Of all the verses in the Bible that that I might know Him. It's not an acquaintance, it's not a visit, not a hangout. Amen. That I might know Him. That I might know Him. And the power of His resurrection. Amen. And so, and what really, really, you know, in His presence there is having that word in the heart, amen. That word if I had word?
In my heart.
That I might, what? So be richly filled with His word over and over and over and over again. So see, when you think like Christ, you'll talk like Christ, and you'll walk like Christ, amen. Because a lot of people around us that, you know, it's like, is He coming again? Well, I don't know when He's coming. I don't know. Do you know when He's coming? But the fact is, it looks very, very, very close, does it not? Very, very close. You know, now, be ready, right? Been in season, out of season, right? Do the work of an evangelist, right? Make full proof of my ministry, right? You know what I'm saying there? So therefore, be armed ready about it,
amen?
Armor ready, right? So have you been attacked today?
No.
Who've been attacked today? Now, if you're not attacked, there's something wrong about it, man. He's coming from the rear. About it, amen. There's no clothing for the back. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. There's no armor for the back. Okay? So if you're running, you know, if you're running away from the Lord, you're running to the enemy. About it,
amen.
And right to His camp. There's no armor for the back, amen. So therefore the armor's for the front, amen.
Amen.
Walking in truth.
Amen.
Having the word of God with His word, amen.
Great is our Lord.
Words cannot put it. There's no words to be found. It's not in a dictionary, man. How great is our God, amen. He's awesome in His splendor, His holiness, His beauty, His righteousness, His mercy, His love, His passion, His healing. I mean, it goes on and on and on. My goodness sakes. You can't exhaust it. You can't exhaust the Lord, amen. David said about God's knowledge. He said, you know what? You examine my heart, you know all about me. When I sit, He knows you're standing right now. He's in front and back and all around you. 139. Said, before I say a word, you know what I'm going to say altogether. Then He goes on, He says, you know what? Says, your knowledge is infinite. That means it's endless, it's immeasurable, it's inconceivable. You can exhaust it. It's just blowing away, amen. That's the Lord that we serve, amen.
on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, I'm standing on the promises of God.
Standing on the promises of Christ the Lord, bound to Him eternally by love's strong cord, overcoming daily with the Spirit's sword, standing on the promises of God.
Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Promises of God.
Standing on the promises, I cannot fall. Listening every moment to the Spirit's call. Resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God.
Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing, I'm standing on the promises of God.